Hi friends, welcome to the class 10 science revision series. And in this video series we are solving the 1 marks, 2 marks and 3 marks and 5 marks questions that are always asked in the board exams, and mostly they have been already asked in the board exams. And for 1 marks we have done 150 questions, for 2 marks we have done 100 questions, and for 3 marks we will be doing 50 questions, and for 5 marks we will be doing 20 questions. So this is the part 2 of the 2 marks questions, and in the first part we solved the first 50 questions of 2 marks, and in this part also we will be solving next 50 questions of 2 marks which are always asked in the board exams. And friends, we have also solved the CBSE official sample paper for class 10th for science and for maths, and for all these videos and all these sample paper solves solutions I have provided the link in the description box. So without wasting our time, let us start the video. And friends, you can also like our Facebook page and show us your love and support on the Facebook page, and this is the address of our coaching and this is the phone number. So let us start the video. How is charcoal obtained from wood? Write two advantages of using charcoal as a fuel over wood. So charcoal is obtained by burning wood in a limited supply of oxygen. Combustion of charcoal is comparatively smokeless, and it has higher heat generation efficiency as compared to the wood. The given experimental setup establishes the responses of different plant parts towards gravity. So give the scientific term used for such response. So when a plant part moves towards any stimulus, and if that stimulus is gravity, then that type of response or movement is known as geotropism. How is shoot response different from the root response movement? So root shows positive movement while the shoot shows negative geotropic movement. Name the parts of brain which control the following activities: blood pressure, riding bicycle, hearing, center associated with hunger. So blood pressure is controlled by hindbrain, riding bicycle is also controlled by hindbrain, and hearing and center associated with hunger is controlled by the forebrain. Given below is the experimental setup to establish that one of the atmospheric gases is essential for the photosynthesis in plants. So name the atmospheric gas which is essential for photosynthesis. So that gas is CO2. What is kept in watch glass in figure A and Y? So KOS, that is potassium hydroxide, is kept in the A glass, and as it absorbs CO2 create an atmosphere which is devoid of CO2. So this KOH absorbs all of the carbon dioxide in this practical, so that is why this is used. A metal is treated with dilute sulfuric acid. The gas evolved is collected by the method shown in the figure. Answer the following. Name the gas. So the gas is hydrogen. Name the method of collecting the gas. The method is downward displacement of water. How can you test whether the gas is combustible or not? So by bringing a burning splinter near the mouth of the gas jar filled with the gas. If the gas burns with a flame, it is combustible. A household uses the following electrical appliances: a refrigerator of 400 watt for 10 hours. So 400 watt for 10 hours. Two electrical fans of 80 watt each for 12 hours. So two electrical fans of 80 watt each for 12 hours. And six electrical bulbs for 6 hours of 18 watts. So this will final come to 4000 watt hour, and this will come to 12 to the 24, and 24 into 8, 4 8 is 32, 8 to the 16, 17, 18, 19. So this will come to be 1920 watt hour, and this will be 36 into 18. So 8 6 are 48, 8 3 is 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, and 1 6 is 6, 1 3 is 3. So 8, 4, 3, 2, 5 and 1, 6, and this will become 6648 watt hour, and finally it will come to be 8615456. So 6568 watt hour is consumed in a day. So for converting this watt hour into kilowatt hour, we will divide this by 1000, and we will have to divide it by 1000, and it is necessary to change this unit in kilowatt hour, because the rate of electric unit which is consumed, that is rupees 3, it is 3 per unit, and per unit means kilowatt hour. So that is why we will have to convert this in kilowatt hour. So 6568 upon 1000, And he's saying that for the month of June, so in month of June there are 30 days, and in each day 3 rupees is consumed. Sorry, 3 rupees is charged for per unit of electricity. So after you will multiply this, finally you will get your answer. So this will be the final calculation. I hope this question is clear to you. What is meant by the term frequency of an alternating current? What is its value in India? Why is an alternating current considered to be advantageous over direct current for a long range of transmission of electric energy? So the frequency of an alternating current is the number of times the direction of the electrical current changes in 1 second, and the frequency value of current in India of alternating current is 50 cycles per second, or 50 hertz you can also say. And at very high voltage the transmission losses are minimized, so that is why alternating current is used apart from the direct current. So at the receiving station the voltage is stepped down for the use. And old person is unable to see clearly nearby objects as well as the distant objects. What defect of vision he is suffering from? So definitely old person suffers from presbyopia. Friends, these three defects of vision, that is myopia, hypermetropia and presbyopia, are very important. Definitely one question comes from these three defects of vision. Mark my words, definitely one question will be coming in your board paper. What kind of lenses will be required to see clearly nearby as well as distant object? Give reasons. So a bifocal lens will be used, and in a bifocal lens both concave and convex lens are used, and the upper portion will be the concave lens, facilitates distant vision, and the lower portion will be the convex lens, it will facilitate the near vision. State two criteria each in the section of each of the following. Good fuel. So good fuel is high amount of heat released on combustion, it is easily available and it produces less smoke. You just have to write any two. And good source of energy, so it should be easily accessible, easy to store and transport, and high efficiency. So you just have to write any two from this three. Name two elements which can be used for generation of electricity in a nuclear power plant. So uranium, plutonium, thorium, you just have to write any two. Why many nuclear power plants could not be installed in our country? Give two reasons. So high cost of installation, environmental pollution and limited availability of the nuclear fuel. Draw the pattern of magnetic field lines of a current carrying solenoid. What does the pattern of field lines inside the solenoid indicate? Write one application of magnetic field of current carrying solenoid. So for this diagram you just consult your NCERT, that is page number 229 and figure number 13.10. So those lines will indicate the pattern of the magnetic field lines, this type of lines. And it indicates that the magnetic field is the same at all points inside the solenoid. And the use or one application for magnetic field of current carrying solenoid is, it is used for making an electromagnet. Out of two solar cookers, one was covered by a plain glass slab and the other was left open. Which of the two solar cookers will be more efficient and why? So the solar cooker with the glass slab, as the heat gets trapped within the cooker and the temperature of the cooker rises, it rises more than the uncovered cooker, or due to the greenhouse effect. In the flowchart given below, fill in the blank spaces with the kind of energy available. So autotrophs use the light energy to make their food and carbohydrates, and in the second part the answer will be chemical energy is generated. By comparing the similarity of nucleotide sequences in DNA of different kinds of organisms, evolutionary relationships can be established. Arrange the following according to their evolutionary closeness. You may use your knowledge of classification also. Whose DNA among these do you think is the most similar to that of the humans? Cockroach, mango tree, gorilla or fish? So first will come gorilla, then fish, then cockroach, then mango tree. And gorilla DNA will be most similar to the humans. Study carefully the following chains given below. Food chain 1, grass, grasshopper, frog. Food chain 2, wheat. Wheat is eaten by the rat. Rat is eaten by the snake, and snake by the hawk. To which of the two consumers, frog or hawk, will more energy be available? So as we know that snake is a secondary consumer while hawk is a tertiary consumer. So at each tropic level, some energy is lost to the environment, and hawk is at the fourth tropic level and the snake is at the third tropic level. So more energy will be available to the snake. As we know that there is a rule of 10% law, so this 10% law applies, and the organisms which come before or initially will get the most energy, and the next organism which eats that previous organism will get the 10% of that energy which the previous organism has. What do the following transport? So xylem transport water and materials, phloem transport sugar, pulmonary veins transport oxygenated blood, and vena cava transport the deoxygenated blood. In test tube A and B shown below, yeast was kept in sugar solution. Which products of the respiration would you accept in test tube A and test tube B? So in test tube A, definitely carbon dioxide plus alcohol will be expected, and in test tube B, carbon dioxide plus water will be expected. Write one feature which is common to each of the following pair of terms or organs: glycogen and starch, so carbohydrates and storage products; chlorophyll and hemoglobin, so these are pigments found in living organisms; gills and lungs, so these are the respiratory organs for exchange of gases; arteries and veins, vessels part of the circulatory system. So this diagram is given and you just have to label any four parts. So this will be the all the parts. With respect to air, the refractive index of kerosene is 1.44. So with respect to air, it is 1.44, and with respect to air, the refractive index of diamond is 2.42. So we have to calculate the RI of diamond with respect to kerosene. So simply, when we will multiply the refractive index of kerosene with diamond, we will get the refractive index of diamond with respect to the kerosene. So 1.44 into 2.42 will be the final answer. You just do the calculation yourself. So during its passage from one medium to another, where does a light ray can change its path? So during its passage from one medium to another, the light ray changes its path at the boundary face separating the two surfaces. Define the term absolute refractive index of a medium. So refractive index is defined as the ratio of speed of light in vacuum to the speed of light in the given medium. And absolute refractive index of a medium is that refractive index when it is compared to the speed of light in the air. Explain with the help of a diagram why a pencil immersed in water appears to be bent at the water surface. So a pencil, this is the pencil ABC, immersed in water appears to be bent at the water surface as shown, and this is the bent part that is shown with the dotted part. It is on account of the bending of ray of light from normal when refraction of light takes place from water, or because of change in the optical density of the medium from air to the water. How are fats digested in the human body? Where does this process takes place? So fats are digested in the small intestine. When food enters small intestine, bile juice secreted by the liver emulsifies fat, and then the enzyme lipase, which is secreted by the pancreas, converts fat into fatty acid and glycerol. When potassium iodide solution is added to a solution of lead nitrate in a test tube, a precipitate is formed. What is the color of the precipitate? So the color of the precipitate will be yellow. Name the compound of the precipitate. So the compound will be lead iodide, that is PbI2. Write the balanced chemical equation for this reaction. So this will be the reaction. What type of the reaction is this? So this is a double displacement reaction. What is a redox reaction? Write down a chemical equation representing it. So a reaction in which one reactant get oxidized while the other gets reduced is called a redox reaction, or a reaction in which both oxidation and reduction happens is also known as a redox reaction, and this is the example. So ZnO is being reduced to Zn and C is being oxidized to Cu. Write the chemical name of baking soda. What happens when it is heated? Write any two uses of baking soda. Friend, the chapter number 3 of your NCRT, that is acid, base and salts. Total 5 salts are given at the end of your chapter in chapter number 3, And friends, mark my words, these all five solves are definitely compulsory, and definitely one question will be coming from these all of the five solves. So learn all of these five solves thoroughly, okay? So chemical name of baking soda is sodium hydrogen carbonate. On heating baking soda, sodium carbonate is obtained. So 2NaHCO3, when it is heated, Na2CO3 plus carbon dioxide plus water is obtained. And uses are that it is used for making baking powder, and it is used in making antacids. An aqueous solution has pH 7. Is this solution acidic, basic or neutral? So this solution is neutral. Which has the higher pH value, 1 mole of HCl or 1 mole of NaOH? So 1 mole of NaOH solution will have a higher pH value. Define the term alloy, right? I need two advantages of making alloys. So alloy is an homogeneous mixture of two or more metals, or a metal and a non-metal. Iron can be made hard by mixing carbon with it, and stainless steel can be made by alloying nickel and chromium with the iron. And alloys are resistant to corrosion. The two uses are that alloys are resistant to corrosion, and alloys are much more stronger than their older metal. What are the constituents of bronze? And write two main uses. Name the common constituents of brass and bronze. So bronze is an alloy of copper and tin. It is used for making medals, and it is used for making statues. And copper is the common metal in brass and bronze. Write one function of each of the following components of the transport system in the human beings: blood vessels, platelets, lymph and heart. Friend, these four functions are given. I am not reading it. You just learn all these four functions. So without wasting our time, let us go to the next question. Stomata of desert plants remain closed during daytime. How do they take carbon dioxide and perform photosynthesis? So such plants take up carbon dioxide during night, which is converted into an intermediate compound. And during daytime, this compound is broken down and the carbon dioxide thus released is used in the photosynthesis. Name and explain the function of hormone secreted by the pituitary gland in the humans. So growth hormone is the hormone which is secreted by the pituitary gland, and this hormone regulates the growth and development of the human body. Explain the mechanism of reflex action with a suitable example. So when we touch a hot object, the stimulus or the response passes through the sensory nerve to the spinal cord. From here, the motor nerve or the motor neuron bring order to the muscles of hand, that is the effector, and the hand is removed from that hot object. So from the hot object, with a fraction of time, this pathway of reflex action is termed as the reflex arc. Draw a diagram to show two resistance of R1, R2 connected in series. So this will be R1 and this will be R2, and these both are connected in series. In a circuit, if two resistance of 5 ohm and 10 ohm are connected in series, how does the current passing through the resistances compare? So suppose these are two resistances of 5 ohm and 10 ohms, and these both are connected in series in any circuit. So this will be the cell and this will be the key. So basically what happens is, when we connect two resistances in series, then both of the resistances will get the same amount of current. Or if we will insert an ammeter in this circuit in series here, so this ammeter will show the same reading which is shown by the 5 ohm resistance or by the 10 ohm resistance. Because friend, there is a concept that in series current remains same in all the devices, and potential difference gets divided, and in parallel the current gets divided across the devices or the resistances, and potential difference remains the same. So this is the concept which you have to remember. And friends, ammeter is connected in series and voltmeter is connected in parallel. Draw a diagram to show the magnetic field lines around a bar magnet. List any two properties of magnetic field lines. So page number 225 of NCERT, figure number 13.4 will be the diagram for this question. And the two properties are, in air field the lines start from the north pole and end towards the south pole, and no magnetic field lines can never intersect each other at any
point. So this point is also very important. A question comes from this point, that why do two magnetic field lines never intersect each other? So you just have to learn this question also. What is a solenoid? So for the diagram of solenoid, consult your NCERT, that is page number 229, figure 13.10. Draw the field lines of a magnetic field line through and around a current carrying solenoid. So a solenoid is a coil of large number of turns, circular turns, or we can also say n number of turns of wire wrapped in the shape of a cylinder. On passing electric current, a magnetic field is developed. And friends, you have to remember that the magnetic field line pattern of a solenoid is totally same as that of a bar magnet. So the field is along the axis of the solenoid such that one end of the solenoid behaves as a north pole and the other behaves as a south pole. Thus, the field of a solenoid is similar to that of a bar magnet. What is the importance in India of hydropower plants? Describe how the electric energy is generated in such plants. So hydropower plants are important because about 25% of energy demand of country is met by the hydropower plants. And hydropower plants convert the potential energy of flowing water into electricity. The water from the high level in the dam or the reservoir is carried through sluice gates and pipes to the turbine located at the base of the dam. And when that water flows through those turbines, that turbines rotate, and in that turbine a dynamo is fitted, and that dynamo converts that mechanical energy into the electrical energy. How is the energy generation in a nuclear fission reaction? Why is large scale of nuclear energy prohibitive? So in a nuclear fission reaction, a little amount of mass is converted so as to generate large amount of energy in accordance with the mass energy equivalence. And large scale use of nuclear energy is prohibitive because of cost of installation of nuclear power plants is very, very high, and there is a risk of leakage of nuclear radiation. Allotropy is a property shown by which glass of substance, elements, compounds or mixtures. Give one example of allotropy. So allotropy is shown by elements, and carbon exists in the allotropic forms, that is diamond, graphite and fullerene are the allotropes of the carbon. An organic compound A is constituent of antifreeze. The compound on heating with oxygen forms another compound B, which has molecular formula C2H4O2. Identify the compound A and B. Write the chemical equation of the reaction that takes place to form the compound B. So friends, whenever this comes, that is C2H4O2. So this is definitely your ethanol, that is this is your definitely your ethanoic acid, that is CH3COOH. So whenever this will come, that what is C2H4O2, that will be definitely in all the questions will be that will be ethanoic acid or the acetic acid, that is the common name of this compound. So the compound antifreeze is ethanol. So the antifreeze compound is ethanol, that is C2H5OH. And when this C2H5OH is heated, on heating oxygen it forms ethanoic acid, that is CH3COOH. So thus the compound A is ethanol and compound B is ethanoic acid. So this is A and this is compound B. The element of the second period of the periodic table are given below: lithium, beryllium, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen and fluorine. Give reasons to explain why atomic radius decreases from Li to F. So as we move from left to right in a period in the periodic table, nuclear charge increases. The nucleus tends to pull the electrons with a greater force, thus decreasing the size of atom. That is the reason the atomic size decreases in moving from lithium to the fluorine. Identify the most metallic and the most non-metallic element. So the Li will be the most metallic element and the F will be the most non-metallic element. Give the symbol for a metal of group 2. So that will be magnesium. A metal of group 13, that will be aluminium. Two non-metals of group 16, oxygen and sulfur, and two reactive non-metals of group 17, that is fluorine. Most reactive non-metal of group 17, that is fluorine. So these are the two differences given between pollination and fertilization. You just have to learn, and there are 3 points given. You just have to write any two in the paper. What is the full form of STD? Give examples. So STD stands for sexually transmitted diseases, and the examples are gonorrhea, syphilis, warts and AIDS, that is acquired immune deficiency syndrome, and the causative organism for AIDS is your HIV, that is human immunovirus. Define variation in relation to a species. Why is variation beneficial to the species? So reproduction process in a species give rise to a new individual that are similar in basic body design but subtly different. These subtle differences are called variations. Some of the variation may survive in the change environment, thus variation helps in continuing the race of the species. Write a note on archaeopteryx. This is also an important question from chapter number 9, that is heredity and evolution. So archaeopteryx is a fossil which have characters of a bird as well as a reptile. Presence of such fossil is an evidence in favor of evolution, which proves that bird have evolved from the reptiles. So there is an object of 5 cm tall. So height of the object is 5 cm. On the principal axis of convex lens. So convex lens is given, so the focal length will be definitely positive. And it is 2 cm. Its 2 cm tall image is formed on the screen, placed at the 10 cm from the lens. So V, that is image distance, will be 10 cm. And height of the image is given, that is 2 cm. So calculate the focal length of the lens. So for finding the focal length of the lens, we just have a simple formula, that is 1 by f is equal to 1 by v minus 1 by u. So we have the value of v in this question, but we do not have the value of u. So we will use the formula of magnification, that is m is equal to v by u, and that is further equal to height of the image upon height of the object. So the value of v will be 10, and u we have to find out, and height of the image is given 2, and height of the object is given is 5. So 2 × 2, 2 × 5 = 10. So u becomes 25 centimeters. So this is the image distance. Now we have to put this value of u and v in this formula. So 1 by v, that is 1 by 10 minus upon 1 by minus 25. I am taking minus here because all the distances, that is u, object distance is always taken as negative. So 1 by 10 plus 1 by 25, the LCM will be 50. So here 5 will come, in here 2 will come, so that will come to be 7 by 50. So 1 by f, so f will be 50 by 7 centimeter, that is in plus sign, and you just convert this value into up to 2 places of decimal, and that will be your final answer. Explain about the color of the sun at the sunrise and the sunset. So at the noon, the sunlight would travel relatively shorter distance before reaching us. So as a result, scattering of blue and violet light is very less and the sun appears white. And in the early morning or in the evening, sun is near the horizon and sunlight passes a longer distance in Earth's atmosphere before reaching us. So most of the blue violet light is scattered away, so it gives reddish appearance to the sun. Briefly explain the cause of dispersion. So when a beam of white light enters a glass prism light ray, when a beam of white light enters a glass prism, the light ray bend towards the normal on entering into the glass. However, different colors of light bend through different angles with respect to the incident ray, and the red light bends at least, while the violet light bends the most. So ray of different colors emerge along different path and thus become distinct, and hence dispersion is caused and spectrum is formed. What are decomposers? Write the role of decomposers in the environment. So decomposers are microorganisms which break up the dead complex organic matter into simple inorganic substances. And the role of decomposers are that they return the nutrient to the soil and they help in completing the biochemical cycle and maintain the ecological system. Describe any four methods of disposal of waste. So four methods are landfilling, recycling, composting and incineration. So in landfills, the method is used to bury the solid waste into a low-lying areas to level of the uneven ground, and in recycling, that waste is processed. This method is used to process the biodegradable waste so that we can use this material again. And in composting, domestic waste can be converted into compost and used as a manure in agriculture. And in incineration, burning of waste to high temperature to form ash is called incineration, and it is used to destroy household chemical and biological wastes. And this process is carried out in an incinerator. What is sustainable development? Suggest any one method to achieve it. So development which can be maintained for a long time without damage to the environment is called sustainable development. And plant more trees and recycle resource to the maximum. So you just have to write any one. Why is conservation of wildlife considered important for us? Give two reasons. So conservation of wildlife is important in maintaining the ecological balance, and wildlife keeps the control over a number of herbivorous plant animals. It is a storehouse of number of articles like wood, herbs, lac and honey. So derive the relation, that is R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 when three resistances are joined in series. So let us perform the derivation. So these are the three resistances that are connected in series, R1, R2, R3, and this will be the cell and this will be the key. So friends, as these all the three resistances are connected in series, so we just learned a concept in few of the slides or few of the questions below, that in series the current remains same in all the devices or all the resistances. So if R1 has I current flowing through it, so R2 will also have I current flowing through it, and R3 will also have I current flowing through it. And the reason behind this is that the current remains same in the combination of series and potential difference gets divided. So here the potential difference will become V1, and here the potential difference will become V2, and here the potential difference will become V3. And this V1 and V2 and V3, the sum of all V1, V2 plus V3 will be equal to the voltage applied through this cell. So V will be equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. So by applying Ohm's law, V1 is equal to IR1, V2 is equal to IR2, and V3 is equal to IR3. So this is equation 1, this is equation 2, this is equation 3. Now add all these three equations, V1 plus V2 plus V3 will be equal to IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. So that will be equal to I bracket R1 plus R2 plus R3, and this V1 plus V2 plus V3 will be equal to V. So V is equal to I bracket R1 plus R2 by plus R3, sorry, and V by I will be equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3, and we have simple Ohm's law, that is V is equal to I into R. So in place of V by I, we can write R from this equation number 4. So R will final come to be R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 after this equation. So this is the derivation. Distinguish between overloading and short circuiting in domestic circuit. So friends, short circuit happens when the live wire and the neutral wire comes in contact, and overloading happens when too many appliances are connected to just one socket and a large current flows in the circuit due to extremely small resistance on account of direct contact of live wire and neutral wire, and in the short circuiting case. And in overloading, large amount of current flow on account of the fact that a number of power appliances or devices are connected and being run simultaneously. So that is why overloading happens, and short circuiting happens when two wires, that is the positive wire and the negative wire, comes both in contact. Although bile juice has no digestive enzymes, it is still considered to be very important during the digestion of food. Give two reasons. So bile salts break the fat into smaller globules and thus increases the frequency of enzyme action. And as we know that bile is alkaline in nature, so it neutralizes the acid enzyme and provides alkaline pH4 enzyme secreted by the pancreas. List any four practices which would help in the protecting our environment. So these are the four practices, like rotation of crops, harvesting of rainwater, proper drainage and irrigation, and judicious use of fertilizers. What is meant by denatured alcohol? What is the need to denature alcohol? So when either methanol or some dye is added to ethanol to make it unfit for drinking, government levies high excise duty on the scale of drinking alcohol. So to prevent the misuse of industrial alcohol for drinking purpose, alcohol is denatured. state the factor on which the resistance of a cylinder conductor depends. Friends, he is asking a very simple question. As all the resistances wire or all the conductors are in the form of cylinder only, so you do not have to get confused in this question. All the wires or all the conductors are in the form of cylinder shape, cylindrical shape only. So the resistance of this conductor depends upon the rho and length and A. So rho is the resistivity of the material, L is the length of the material, and A is the area of cross section of this cylinder. So it is directly proportional to L, inversely proportional to the area of cross section, and depends on the nature of the material. So R is directly proportional to rho, R is directly proportional to L, and R is inversely proportional to area of cross section. Why two magnetic field lines do not intersect each other? Explain. Friends, this is very important question. So two magnetic field lines cannot intersect each other at any point, because if they intersect, it means that there are two possible directions of magnetic field lines there and two tangents at one point, which is not possible. So suppose this is the first magnetic field line, this is the second magnetic field line, and now we have a common point for these of both of these two magnetic field lines which are intersecting at this point. So but the concept is that at any one single point only one tangent can be drawn. For this single point only one tangent can be drawn, so that is not possible. So friends, I hope all the questions are clear to you and these questions helped in your board exam. So do give it a thumbs up and share it as much as possible, and if you have any doubts then you can ask me in the comment section and I will be happy to reply as soon as possible. Friend, this was the series of question number of the 2 marks question, and in the upcoming series or in the upcoming videos we will be doing the almost minimum 50 questions of 3 marks and 20 questions of 5 marks. So stay tuned and subscribe Maths and More to get the instant updates. Thank you.